Basically, there are two types of stances. Number one is your regular stance. You're like this, but your body is pointing at a 45 degree angle, but your face, you're looking straight at your opponent. What are the advantages of this stance? Number one advantage, the biggest advantage is only one side is open for the opponent to hit. This side is basically covered behind your shield and it's way too far away from the opponent. So this punch and this kick will have a huge amount of power because it will take more momentum to strike. So the more the momentum is, the more the power is. Is basically, you know, the further the distance is, the more power you will be able to generate. The best advantage of this stance is you can play chicken. You know, you can do a gorilla, single gorilla warfare with it. How? I punch, I immediately come back. I can irritate the person with this. I can play with my opponent. I can go side, play, irritate him. Like a wasp, I can keep on stinging. Bam, 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 bam. And the person will get irritated, will lose his mind, lose his strategy, right? So I can set the table with this so that I can throw a powerful strike, a knockout punch. And this won't be as powerful as this hand. Your lead hand will not be as powerful as your back hand. But you can make your lead hand as lethal. You can get a KO, in fact, out of your lead hand if you follow the Jack Dempsey advice of jabbing, right? I will show you. So imagine you are on a step stool, okay? You are throwing your body forward, you're throwing your body and transferring all that body weight energy into your hand. So you're throwing your body weight forward and generating energy, generating force with that, and transferring that force onto your hand. First, look at from this angle, okay? See, I'm on a step stool or on a step ladder on a staircase, and I'm coming down from a staircase, okay? So while coming down, I jab and bring it back. Okay, bring it back, bring the guard back, okay? And the second disadvantage is, if I extend my leg too much far away from me, if I take it too much far in and the guy is, you know, he's waiting for this leg to come out of my safe distance, my safe bubble. So I simply step forward to throw a big punch, a Jack Dempsey punch, you know, I'm throwing my weight forward and throwing this punch. What will happen if he dodges my jab? He's gonna give me a roundhouse on my knee and my knee will snap. Now the second stance is 90% similar. See, this is your first stance, right? This is your first stance. All you're doing is you're pointing your nipples towards your opponent. In your first stance, you're pointing it towards a 45 degree angle. Now you're pointing it towards your opponent. That's it. That's your second stance. It is also called a square stance. You can immediately gauge a disadvantage. A huge disadvantage is your whole body is available. Your, you know, everything, both of the ribs, solar plexus, bladder, everything is available. Mediastinum, the heart, everything is available for your opponent. But it has an advantage. Now my both hands are equally strong. Very less power difference. Very less, almost negligible power difference. So you might feel like a Bheem, like a Hulk, you know, in this stance. Okay, it is way more, it feels good, it is, but the whole footwork changes. It's difficult to go in and out. It is difficult to do certain things with this stance, what you can do with your first stance. But it is good at close quarters. You know, when you are at close quarters, when you are not doing this, when you are aggressive, you can simply go in, go side, you can easily move around. If somebody says that, you know, it's you are easy to take it down on the ground, yes, it is. But if you know how to defend yourself, you might not be, or the opponent might not be. So, how to cover the disadvantages of both the stances? You learn how to switch. Instead of entering into debates, that which stance is the best, you know, which stance is the undisputed, the champion stance, you know, because your master had taught this, you know, this, you might ruin your career because of the square stance, you know, and this stance is the best stance. You learn to switch, okay? You adapt, you learn to switch from this to this. One, two, one, two, one, two. That's it, see, square stance, normal stance, square stance, normal stance, square stance, normal stance. There are many ways to switch. So instead of getting into debates, learn both the stances from both the sides, okay? Now the right, right, right. Learn to operate, be ambidextrous, okay? Learn to operate in both the stances from both the sides. Be ambidextrous. Who told you that you have to just learn one stance and one stance only and, you know, just deal with it? No, switch. Keep switching. If you see most MMA fighters, Muay Thai fighters, they switch a lot. All the time. I will give you examples in my later videos. I'm gonna break some conventions, some beliefs that people are holding, you know, this is the only rule, this is the grandfather rule of all martial arts and you should not break and never break whatsoever. Turns out many people have used traditional martial arts and mingled with current martial arts and made something hybrid, a zombie martial art of their own in MMA. UFC, I'm talking about UFC.